Hi, I'm Hans Peter, and welcome to this lesson today, AC/DC style guitar. First of all, when we talk about AC/DC, I think every rock guitar player or every guitar player or even non-guitar player knows this band. And the very interesting thing about AC/DC is that when you go through the songs, I mean, with some exceptions, basically they play with four chords, and more or less they are the same four chords with some variations. And this kind of playing are these chords. These four chords, actually. And they define more or less the style of AC/DC, or define more or less a specific rock guitar style. Which spreads through other bands. Like, I remember one band that were called Rose Tattoo, was from Australia as well, and they sounded pretty similar like AC/DC, of course, because they were using these chords. But when it comes to these chords, it's not so easy as some might think. Okay, this is beginner stuff, I mean, I can play this. But the trick is, these guys, or especially this one rhythm guitar player, that's Malcome Young, he plays these chords, I think, his whole life. And there are some tricks behind it, which you need to know, that you really have this specific sound. And this lesson is about how to work with these four chords and get into this AC/DC style, which is very useful for any kind of rock guitar, because this playing style, or this playing technique, is a specific playing technique, is actually useful for any kind of blues rock, whatever you want to play. Is really this what we're learning is essential for all other kinds of styles which you use this kind of playing, which is pretty broad. First of all, so we talk about sound settings. Sound settings, of course, are also essential. You need a distorted amp, of course. Tube amp would be best, because there you can really work out the dynamics. I'm here on this pickup here. I have a British amp. Gain level is around maybe 6 or 7. You can also go to 10 if you want. And then you work with the volume knob, or if you have a volume pedal, with the volume pedal. And here, I mean, if you have the volume knob on 10, you have full distortion. And if you have the volume knob like on 5, the distortion is still there, but it depends how hard you attack the strings. If you attack them hard, you still have a pretty saturated distortion. But to really achieve this, you need to get the technique behind it. So you can switch between the dynamics. You can play soft, or you can play hard. That's actually the trick behind it. Or you can switch between one playing level, you just attack soft. And one trick I use is I hold the pick a little bit loose, that it nearly drops out of my hand, and just go through. When I take hard, I really hold it tight, and then now if I want to have more distortion, I put the volume knob up. That's really essential. Now let's check out the chords, of course, first. Now the chords are so simple that even Forrest Gump could have invented them. Basically it's E5. And now it's very essential that you really know which strings are attacked. So we have E5, we attack the low three strings, and you need to hold the finger in a way that you also can attack hard. That was too hard. You heard that the lowest string got a little bit detuned, and this is happen when you attack too hard. You have to attack dynamic but not too hard. That's the trick. And the G note here is stamped through this finger. That's is very essential, because then you really can go attack dynamically and really go through the strings in a very steady and confirmed movement of your on your picking hand, and then you get this really typical sound, which is and it's not about the amp. You can have it on any tube amp. Then we have G or G5, that you're there using two of them. So the G, just finger in the third fret, A string got stamped, and then you attack the E string, the D string, and the G string. And it's not too bad if the B string also is ringing. But basically, it's a G5 chord. Or you can make the maximum G5. You have here the ring finger in the third, and now you really can go through the strings dynamically. And now if you play it soft, see the difference. Then just go softly over the strings, as I said, with the pick, which is hold a little bit loose. Or a hard. Then we have D5. This is actually my favorite chord of all these. Here the third, second. Now with the thumb, you damp the E string, and with the middle finger you damp the high E string. So you play the middle four notes, and if you attack hard, you really go through dynamically. See, and you can really go through because the other strings are damped. And then last but not least, of course, A5. So you can also damp the low E string with your thumb. And you attack these three strings here, the A, D, and G string. But not the B string. That one would sound, that doesn't sound nice. So you also hold the finger in a way that the B string is damped, and the high E string you should not attack. So now we have it. Now when you listen to me, you think, okay, it sounds pretty clean, but it's not so easy. You really have to work your technique, that you really attack these chords the way they should be. So now let's check out a little example. Now when we work with these chords, you have any kind of combinations which work. Any kind of combinations work. We can all I just give two examples for today, that's enough, and the rest is up to you, which you can develop. And of course, there are some AC/DC tunes which work different, but a lot of them work this way, and for me this is really style defining. It's like AC/DC defined as a kind of a style, guitar playing style. So it's not only for me AC/DC, it's more style. So now let's have the first example. Is this one here. So we're playing E5, D5, A5. Now the trick that you really sound cool is you have one chord on beat and like two syncoped, like when you now have this. So this one is on 1, 2, 3, 4, and on 4 and comes the next 1, 2, 3, 4 and, see, and it's with a downstroke, it's not altered picking. That's the really trick behind it, that you really sound this with a 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2 and 3. And the second one is also syncoped here in this case on two end. So you have syncopations on four end or two end. And then you have a mixture between on beat, off beat, and this is really what makes it. So one, two, three, four, and one, two, and three, four. So let's check it out with the track, how it sounds. One, two, three, four. Track here we have a second example, and this is the other one. So the first one was just laying chords, 1 2 3 4, and this is just laying chords. The second is more rhythmic, so we have this little pattern, so 1 and 2, and so we also have on beat, off beat. See, the first one is on 1 and 2 and 3, and we lay down the chord on four end, and this mixture between this rhythm stuff with eights and syncoped chords makes it. See? And then again, the same rhythm pattern. One and two and three, four. Now comes the dynamics. So if you want to work, since the structure is very simple, dynamics is very important. So you can now work with the dynamics. First we put down the volume a little bit, so we start easy. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1. In this case you can really keep it soft, and then you gain the dynamics. 1, 2, 3. Now we're coming more. So we have this climax in it, and then we have the second part here, like in this example we could go for full, we have the volume note of a maximum and really attack hard, and then we go back to softer volumes. And that's the main thing, working with simple things but creating music, creating dynamics. That's the whole thing behind it. So let's check it out. And so on. That's basically what Malcome Young is doing since I think 40 years now. But it's, there's a worse job on this planet than that one. Now we're coming, we don't going too much now into the lead guitar, because this is of course more complex, but if you want to really go into typical AC/DC lead guitar, then of course you need a Gibson SG guitar. This guitar has a pretty aggressive sound, which I personally don't like too much. But I mean, it's this style. You can do it, but we can do it with any other guitar, of course. Just same sound, same British amp. Gain level, you can have a higher gain level. And then, oops, I'm here having a little technical problem with my chair. So, fixed it. Let's check it out. I'll take another one here. Now we have more gain, but Angus Young is really using practical no delay. I think he has absolutely no delay on the lead sound, on the rhythm sound, on the rhythm guitar sound. There's no reverb at all, really no reverb, no delay, just really very dry but very tight played. Now you hear when I have more distortion level now. Now it doesn't really sound the same way as before. But now coming to the lead guitar, this case is typical pentatonic licks, and that's more or less kind of bluesy stuff. I think this is too much distortion here. That's not really typical. Now let's see a few examples, and then we have it done. This AC/DC style lesson, pretty cool. In this case, of course, we're in E. And as you remember, one song. Work with open string. Typical, this one song which has a kind of a rhythm pattern like this. Working with the open string, that's pretty cool. You can work with open string here. Here in the open position, 3rd, 5th, 7th, 10th and 12th fret. On the B string you can do the same thing, open, 3rd, 5th, 8th, 10th, 12th. And then more or less just pentatonic. And of course in the position number one, high position, you can work with the typical bendings here, 12, 15 bend, with these typical rock bendings. So let's give it a shot. I don't know what we work out now. Some ideas here. What is very typical for Angus Young is this repeating thing. Here we're on the 12th, bending in the 14th. Go up in the bending and then work with the open string. And the rest is just typical work with the bending. And that's it, more or less. Actually, the soloing is not really too much style defining for my taste. I mean, I like the playing of some tunes. I think there was one song, I don't remember the name, which I really liked the soloing. But for me personally, I just don't like the sound of this Gibson SG too much. But it's great what he's playing, but more or less it's just typical rock guitar stuff with a lot with open strings and these repeating patterns. And then you can really go for it.